How you do? Yeah, just playing some more Shadow of Mordor for my Saturday releases on the YouTube. So, yeah, catch me live on Twitch at AlexCloud225. Or, for most Saturdays for a while now, watch the Shadow of Mordor playthrough. Should be fun, should be good. I'm gonna have fun with it anyway. So we're just gonna jump into episode 3. Lane politics.
I am with child. Talion's child.
I was offered a post commanding the Black Gate. I intended to refuse. I shall hide you both there.
Thank you, Hollis.
This is not for you. I do this for my daughter.
Ooh, there's a worm. Back on a billy point. Get the elven run going. Invulnerable to ranged, heavy attacks, high damage and melee, cannot be countered, has a group of followers, vulnerable to mounted beasts, and fears cargoes. Super jump there, but that's far bad.
Tower, the elf
dwarven stones luminous as if they were cast from light.
Clam.
My ancestral doom, I must push away with light.
There was a bat outbreak of ghoul in Noor, so we're going to be joining forces with the war chief there.
Thank you. Please help me rescue my brother. He's far too stubborn to work for these Uruk.
Big thing well enough alone.
Why don't you come over here, Ranger? Don't tell me you're scared.
Spirit of Mordor. Sours Uruks frequently superuse lesser orcs in their violent struggles for power. Investigate how the power of the Wraith can exploit these struggles, piercing weak minds to bring down the enemy forces from within. One orc mine in particular shines as a blazing beacon of weakness.
It's weak.
Major,
brainwashing.
Come close if you want the black hand. Those slave scum are pouring poison in your ear. Oh, but you cut these ropes. Ratbag will tell you everything.
Now, what would you know that all these other dead orcs didn't?
Go ahead, you bastard! Do it! I'll die, and you'll know nothing!
Maybe I'll grant your request. End your miserable life.
No. I was jesting. Look, those slaves are no match for the orc army. Their schemes as rotten as barrel fish. Ratbag can teach you the ways of the orc. Ratbag can make your plan work.
They are a bit common English, aren't they?
We're going to find out what you know.
Slut Goroff. Goroff the cargo tamer. Awesome, you have the worst habit of like talking to me when a cutscene's on. Even though I spend like 20 minutes just fucking around, running around in circles where I'm available to chat. It's just suddenly a cutscene's on and you're just like, ah, well, conversation time.
I don't know what you want me to do. I don't want to leave you alone, but I got stuff to do.
No, it's perfectly fine. I'm playing in the middle of the day instead of the middle of the night.
Those slaves will stab you in the back. At least an Uruk will stab you in the front. Most likely the throat. We have similar goals, Ranger. See, you want to kill the captain, and somebody's got to take his place. Somebody like Ratbag.
So this Goroff is in charge?
Of this camp, yeah. But he's no war chief. They answer directly to the Black Hand. I'll show them all when I'm in the Black Hand's inner circle. Becoming a captain is just the first step of Ratbag's plan to become a war chief.
Then prepare to step hard on his neck.
How did you get free, scum?
New enemy defenders. Defenders will block your front on attack and must be hit from behind. Press X when they're in sleep over them. Oh, shouldn't
the Ranger, not me. He's a much easier target. His sword's broken.
Leave the vermin alone and face me, Uruk.
Oh.
away. The pain just made his bar more tender.
Let's do. Well done, Ranger. Now, just picture all these corpses as Gorov. Visualize your goals. Gorov's been out for Ratback for years. Smug piece of dung he is. We come to blows as far back as Ratback can remember. Still, Ratback never wins. Last time, he kicks Ratback into the Caragor pit. All the others laugh as the Caragor bats Ratback around like a yarn ball. Oh, that Gorov's gonna pay. Smug piece of dung, he'll pay. Gorov keeps Caragors in pens. And rumor has it, he doesn't like to get too close to them.
And let me guess, you think I should open those pens?
Gorov's always in there. Never leaves, ever. Wonder where he pees. Oh, that explains the smell.
Keep out of sight. I'll see that your captain gets demoted.
Splendid plan. You kill, I wait. That's military genius, that is. Come, Gorov's right up ahead. I'm salivating with anticipation. The drool of revenge.
He's just following orders from the war ships. It's them what's got all the crows. Bleed you, weakling. Cougar found some tracks. It's doubled on the fences.
We don't want to waste their life. Come on, Alex. Patience. Patience. Yeah, retry, because it just jumped me on the wrong bloody person. That was annoying. There was a crossbow guy right underneath me. I was like, yeah, jump in stealth kill. Just jump all the way down to the bottom into a group of like four people.
Soon enough, beg me for mercy!
might as well pick up this artifact while I'm here. No forced patience. Grog Bowl! The myth of the filthy, crude, encrusted Uruk Grog Bowl is just that. Uruk trainers beat it into their charges to keep their Grog Bowls as clean as possible to avoid the old soldier's disease. Using these bowls are commonly made of clay and baked in kilns, but Mordor has proved fruitful realm for the Uruks, and now some bowls are made of metal or wood.
We'll go tonight. No more being bossed around by that damned Urukai. We'll sneak into the barracks and bleed that spark dry. He won't be so high and mighty when he's dead. And we'll run the place. You and me. Balls for us.
Face me? More grog? We won't be going hungry, as a fact.
Appendices. What are we? Tutorials again? What are you trying to teach me? Dodge, herbs, drain, attract, distract, bait caragors. New enemies, defenders.
But I heard them strange sounds again.
This grog they have is a harsh but effective medicine.
These Uruk truly are twisted reflections of my kin.
Bolts told me we should get ready to march out of here soon and I could shoot gold. I wonder if an Uruk has ever gone from arch of a captain.
This looks like a good spot to get some shut-eye. Goroth will kill you if he catches you napping. Goroth never comes here. He's always by the hunting camp.
Goroth's in the hunting camp. So much for him always being in the same place. A captain who fears his own beast.
Fear is a powerful tool, Talion. Let's put Goroth's to work.
One of this filth is Goroth.
Someone sneaking about.
Goroth.
When I walk the plains of Mordor, I find caragors by the sound of them running away from me.
Battle reports. After power struggles, battle reports will recap the events of and shifting power of Sauron's army. Press the right button to view the battle report.
You two! Hey! Hey! I need you to take a body back to my tent. I'm gonna get me a trophy.
Get lost, scum!
We only take orders from Gorov.
That's the filthy corpse I need you to carry! Now go! Go!
Set your fish
Be respectful, you dunghill worms! Or it'll be your ear next time! Ratbag is your captain now!
Let's go take a gander.
Yeah, and when you're done with that, I've got more bodies for you to carry. Meet me at the crossroads. An old friend there is about to lose his head.
Spirit of Mordor.
First I'm resurrected by a wraith, now I am working with an orc. What could possibly be next?
We must use the weapons of our enemy against him. The orcs hate each other almost as much as they hate us.
I just want to... Go on, I got space for now. Let's go to my prerequisite, my appendices. And read some stuff about some characters. It's Ratbag. Ratbag the Orc craves power without knowing... what he would do with it. He cannot heft a heavy weapon over his head, but he will, stupidity perhaps, attempt to claw his way to the top of Sauron's army by aligning with his people's great enemy, the Gravewalker. He has deluded himself into believing the Ranger will help him become a war chief, and once he has the power, he'll be able to keep all he will be able to keep all he has achieved. His many scars bear witness to his ineptitude and history of failure. He is a craven little thing whose only chance of success is in spite of himself. Alright, more tutorial. Now, what is this side first? Way to be on the Isle of Miles. Using anyone foolish enough to peer over the ramparts to take his target practice. Forge the legend of the Bow of Khazad. As Carl.
with someone.
How's it going? How was the call?
Oh, sorry.
Okay.
I see the Ranger.
I've got to find a way to kill 6 more people without moving out of this orange circle, but they've got to be the yellow people as well. Right. See that guy? No, I've got to do that guy. There we go. There it is. I think I should be able to get him. There we go. Congratulations, me. Ability point gained. Let's bread some Karagors. Press R1 to mount a Karagor from above. Once mounted, you can ride and climb and fight with them. Cool. Alright, that's a moped. Woo. I thought an air siren was going off. I was like, is Russia attacking? Is that a moped? Where are we looking? What's next? First I've got to get some pipweed and kill some spiders, damn. And that's inside the temple. Okay. Get the ethyl in. Strength and weaknesses. Hand of killeth Ithrin. Where are we? Lore. Excuse me, guys. I have to read a book. Dorth Hong. A Gondorian stronghold built in Undin after the defeat of Sauron by the last alliance. Dorth Hong stood watch over Karak Hagan and the lands beyond it. Rangers posted at the garrison patrolled Utin for more than 1,000 years, but attrition, invading Eastlings, and the Great Plague weakened their ranks. Eventually, the stronghold became impossible to hold. It was abandoned by the Third Age of Middle-earth in TA 1640, and since Sauron's return, has been taken over by Uruks as a military fortress.
Thank you.
talk is too scared to stick around.
Palgador, Gador, Dagor. More intel to gather. The artifact. In the northern part of it. There. Yep. Boom.
Boom. You should have seen the damage one of our hunters did to a soft skin yesterday. Murder, she wrote. Murder, she wrote. Horn. This horn heralded by the great victory at the end of the Second Age by the Last Alliance at the Battle of Dangolard. It blew in defiance of the Mouth of Sauron's assembled army of more than 300,000
1,000 orcs. And the Dark Lord himself, who ruled over the forces of the land against the men and elves. It sounded the charge of the battle plane and serenaded the fallen dead, those unfortunate souls who would be forever doomed to haunt the dead marshes.
They say the enemy is weak on the left, and that the dwarves will tear through them there. Maybe then we can leave these filthy marshes and go home. Yesterday, the enemy made a call for parley. We saw the emissary's party ride out, a terrible black figure atop a black horse, and flanked by two huge men, similarly clad in black. They were not allowed to ride among our lines, amid suspicion they would scout our disposition and report back to their vile master. Instead, a small group of elves and men rode out to meet him. We could not hear what was said, but there will be no peace. Around the camp there are whispers. They say the emissary's mouth blackened and burned with Sauron's words, and that saying them caused the emissary great pain. He promised only slavery and toil, and I am compelled to believe it. I cannot help but think we will never make it into Mordor. Only death awaits us here.
Damn. What was this? Nature. Morgoth flies. With Mordor's predilection for unburied corpses, Morgoth flies have become a mainstay. Their nests can be found hanging anywhere. There might be flesh, and any disturbance sends the insects into a frenzy. When this happens, the malevolent creatures swarm, working in concert with one another, creating a relentless stinging mass powerful enough to overwhelm even an armor-clad orc. The red markings on their backs are reminiscent of the blazing eye of Sauron, and these creatures are extensions of his dark spirit.
Caragor! You're finished!
Deerhail said that he saw ghosts on the dead marshes. I thought he just saw his own fear.
The sleepless dead, the shadow men, the dead ones. Mordor calls to them all.
Oh, okay. That's my bad. Like, making you laugh. I unleash you. Oh, hell, like, don't try and hunt me down. Just throwing that out there. Descend on the enemy camp, he cut off the Dark Lord's supply of new recruits. On that day, the trainees learned only of death. Forged the legend of the Sword of Uruk-hai. Enter the trainees, melee execute. X mini orcs. Okay. Pick that up. I am Trevor Avon. Focus first. Okay.
The commute by bus is 1 hour and 15 minutes.
Okay.
And because it's only for 4 hours a week, taking it by bus would be more.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah. So I put, but I, with the same company, I did apply for another one.
Yeah.
They did a good job setting up a door thing.
Gotta make sure our armories are protected.
Only thing keeping them out weapon supplies is us.
Get caught doing that, you'll be paying a visit to the
beast. Oh yeah. Yeah, you're limited by your commute. Like, an hour walk isn't as bad as an hour bus. Because, like, sure, it's gonna suck to walk for an hour, but you can listen to like a podcast or a radio or something. But yeah, once it gets to public transport, you're hoping to work for like multiple days.
Yeah.
Like you can sacrifice a half an hour each side of your shift for your public transport, but
yeah,
too much isn't worth.
That was the other thing, is like because it's only 2 hours, 2 days.
Mm.
A bus ride just to get back.
No, that'll be probably more than 3. I mean, sure there's day riders and stuff, but still even the day riders are maybe like 4 or 5 times. Mm. Yeah. No, I get it. It's a struggle, but like that's why you need to have like strong yeses and strong no. You need to know where your lines are. I know how to kill things, game. Don't constantly remind me that of how to murder. I know what I'm doing. I'm doing my little side quest thing. Ah, damn it, my combo. Where am I looking? Alright, sent me over there, but no, that sad quiz.
I saw what the Grave Walker did to them explosives. Set them off. Over here. Kill. archer and a hunter. Be a hunter. Because their spears make a much bigger mess of an enemy than any arrow can.
Running. His enemy's arrow dug in the sky. He moved to eliminate the archers and clear a path for his forces. Forge the legends of the Dagger of its Arm.
I've had enough of the food. Time we marched off elsewhere. You won't have to wait long. Saw a captain from Nurn here a few days ago. Nurn? I know how to go there. Place bloody reeks of fish. They got lots of soft skin there, though. We got bloody to eat.
After a bad winding food and grog, instead we get nothing but a lot of noise from the boss.
You'll get a lot more nothing if you keep whining about it.
He's right. I think something just moved. You're weak. I'll show you weak if you gobs don't shut up. Just my imagination. We'll have action.
Alright, I've got to do some ledge kills.
Did I just hear something?
Training. It's time we killed something. Wait! A dead Uruk!
Who's itching to trap a few Tatagors?
Get my archers in the line.
There's something about it. You are the bravest of Uruk got a bottle. Give it.
What was that?
Such a good time, sneaky, sneaky. Kill orcs in a line. Forget about the match kills, it's just start jumping on people.
Did you hear
it to.
Just because we haven't seen him, don't mean he's not close by. Swear, I heard him breathing. That was no wind. Clear out your ears, you filthy glob.
Sneaking about.
Two more and a man.
We've got a killer lurking around.
I just need a lot more power, and I can start spending ability points again. Until then, we'll get a health upgrade. Hey guys, thank you very much for watching. Again, do any follows, comments, likes, and subscribes that you want to do. And I'll be back after I take a break with the next part. And you'll see it the Saturday next week of the release of the other one, because that's how these things work on YouTube. Until then, press buttons, do things, enjoy your life. Catch you later.